The World Health Organization warns that West Africa could see up to 10,000 new cases of Ebola per week within 2 months. The United Nations Health Agency also says the death rate in the current outbreak has increased. 70% of those who get it die. Meanwhile, in the United States, the CDC still has no idea how the 26-year-old Dallas nurse got infected with Ebola. Nina Pham was on the team caring for Thomas Eric Duncan, who died last week. Pham, a critical care nurse, was wearing a mask, shield, and gloves.
A single infection in a healthcare worker is unacceptable. And what we're doing at this point is looking at everything we can do to minimize that risk so those who are caring for her do that safely and effectively.
Pham has received a potentially life-saving transfusion from Dr. Kent Brantley, the missionary who recently survived Ebola. His body is now packed with antibodies to fight the virus. The procedure appears to be working. Nina Pham is now in stable condition. Meanwhile, health officials continue to monitor the situation and are meeting about it regularly to keep everyone on their feet in case Ebola were to come here. KXLY4's Allie Norton joins us live from the Sky Deck with details on their efforts. Allie.
Aaron, the Spokane Regional Health District is certain that they are not only prepared, but also ready if Ebola were ever to come here. Now, that being said, they're taking precautions and making sure that everyone who would respond is on the same page.
Normal monthly meetings to talk about hazard plans have lately been centered around Ebola. Today at the Washington Healthcare Coalition discussion, it was making sure that all 10 Eastern Washington counties have an Ebola protocol.
The topic of Ebola is certainly of interest to make sure that we're coordinating messages, we're able to provide the care that we're designed to do.
Susan Joburg, Spokane's emergency response coordinator, says they've recently started putting out weekly reports locally to healthcare providers, an effort so that anyone who is likely to find themselves taking care of an infected person has the tools and knowledge to act accordingly.
To get them into quick isolation, to reduce exposures, to make sure we're communicating with each other across the whole healthcare system.
Right now, it's just monitoring the situation and making sure it doesn't come here. Their next step is to conduct a plan at the airport. While there's no direct flights to any of the countries with Ebola, health officials still want a backup plan in case a plane ever had to be diverted here.
It's what we do in healthcare, and though Ebola is different and a disease that we haven't dealt with in the United States before, it's communicable disease, protocols, and processes to help contain any kind of infectious agent.
And now the quarantine and immigration offices over at SeaTac is actually the one that's going to be providing those guidelines to how to handle a medical emergency like Ebola. So the regional health district here will be working with them on that to implement something similar at Spokane International. Reporting from the Sky Deck tonight, I'm Allie Norton, KXLY 4 News.